Good morning, children. Welcome to Lakshmi Study Room. Today our topic is Part 5 video in water lesson from 6th class new science textbook. Today we will going to learn about water cycle and what is water cycle and what are the steps involved in this process. So when it rains, ponds, lakes, etc. are filled with water. Water that comes from the rainfalls runs down a small streams. These small streams join together and make bigger streams. These bigger streams join the rivers, and these rivers flow down to seas, oceans, and some of this rain water seeps into the ground and becomes, it is formed as a underground water. This is during rainy season situation. Now, while coming to the summer, as it is very hot during summer, large quantity of water evaporates from the seas, lakes, rivers, etc. and converts into water vapor. And this water vapor goes up in the air, sea. Take for example, this is a river. From the river, during hot sun, what will happen? The water from the lakes, it gets evaporated and reaches the atmosphere. It moves higher level, then it will be formed as a clouds. These clouds again cool and give rain. So whenever the cool air will be reaches to the cool wind or cool breeze reaches to the clouds, then only the clouds gets cooled and the clouds cannot hold the water droplets, and it will be formed as a in the tiny droplets that will be called as in the form of a rain. So the circulation of the water between the earth surface and air is called water cycle. So what is water cycle? The circulation of the water between the earth surface and air is called water cycle. It is also called as the hydrological cycle. Hydro means water, so it is a biological process. This will be called as a hydrological cycle. So what is hydrological cycle? The circulation of the water between the earth surface and air. Here, so this is a earth surface. The water will be turned move into the air. So the circulation between what circulation of water between the earth surface to air will be called as a water cycle, hence it is also called as a hydrological cycle. So this water cycle can be summarized as follows. That means this water cycle contains four main stages. The first one is a evaporation, second one is a condensation, third one is a precipitation, and fourth one is a collection and runoff. The first one is evaporation. Liquid changes to gas. That means the water changes into water vapor with the help of sunlight. Sun heats up the water bodies effect. And what is the reason how water changes into water vapor? Cause for the sun heats up the water bodies. And what is the effect of evaporation? Liquid water becomes water vapor. That means that changes into gas and reaches into the atmosphere. And the second one is a condensation. That means gas becomes liquid. That means vapor turned into water. So gas becomes liquid. Cause, what is the cause for? Vapor rises into the air, then it gets cool with the help of cool air or cool breeze. And what's the effect of condensation? The effect of condensation is water vapor changes into liquid water or clouds. Precipitation. So what are the reasons? Precipitation. What is precipitation? Water or frozen water falling to the earth. That means the water will be falling on the earth in the form of tiny droplets. The tiny droplets will be called as a rain. Rain, sleet, snow or hail. So water are frozen water falling to the earth will be called as a frozen water falling to the earth will be called as a precipitation. And what's the cause of precipitation? Cloud droplets becomes too heavy, they form. Cloud droplets, whenever the cloud droplets become too heavy, then clouds do not hold the that water droplets. So then only it will falling on the earth. And effect of precipitation. So precipitation is in four forms: rain, snow, sleet, hail. So rain means liquid form, snow means fog form, sleet means small ice form, ice cubes, hail means somehow it is a large pieces of ice cubes. Okay, so it is hail. Hail we can call it as a vadagundlu. Collection and runoff. Next, water soaks into the ground. So water, that means the rain will be soaks into the ground. What is the cause for the collection? Water collects on the earth's surface. Sometimes it flows up before collecting. Effect. And what is the effect? Lakes, ponds, oceans, rivers, streams, all will be filled with the rainwater. So deforestation and pollution from the factories are now causing for global warming. In the earlier video, they asked one question, and what's the reasons for the changing or not getting rains properly in season wise. So the main causes for these deforestation and pollution from factories are causes for global warming. So the atmospheric conditions are not favorable for clouds to get cold. So that means these global warming rise up the atmosphere temperature. The temperature will be high due to global warming. So then whenever the temperature is very high, the clouds do not get cold. There is no chance to clouds do not get cold. So consequently, there is a decrease in rainfall. This distribute the water cycle and this disturb the water cycle and causes either less rainfall or too much rainfall. So less rainfall, what happens if less rainfall, and what happens too much rainfall? Take for example, less rainfall leads to drought conditions. Much rainfall leads to flooding. Floods. Now let us observe what is the causes for reason. Okay, what is the reason for? And if less, what happens if there is less rainfall? If the less rainfall causes less production of crop yield, that means food production will be less, grains will be reduced, pulses will be less production of crop yield, and depletion of water levels. Water level will be depleted. Depleted means less or decreasing. So depletion of water level and water scarcity. People do not have a sufficient water to drink and irrigate the crops and fodder for the animals. Okay, so water scarcity and atmospheric temperature is also raises. So these are all the temperature is also raises. So what happens if there is less rainfall? Less rainfall leads to less production of crop yield and depletion of water levels and water scarcity, and there is no drinking water is scarce, and people need to travel long distance to collect the water, and soil becomes dry. Agriculture and cultivation is also becomes difficult. People migrate to other places to search for jobs also, and even animals also difficult to get food and fodder. And if much rainfall, and what happens, much rainfall leads to floods. So loss of human life, damage to properties and damage to crops, and loss of livestock, deforestation of health. Deforestation leads to, that means lot of trees will be destructed, and destruction of power plants, roads, and damage of the roads, and even some destruction of bridges also. People forced to leave their own home, and disruption of supply of clean water, transport, electricity, communication. So all these will be disturbed with the much rainfall. So these are all the reasons. And do you know there are four main types of precipitation? Already we have discussed. There are rain, sleet, snow and hail. Here they gave each and every one clearly, and the definition also here gave. Each type begins either water droplets or ice crystals in clouds. The temperature of the lower atmosphere determines which form of the precipitation will take as it falls. That means rain, sleet, snow, hail. It always depending on the how much temperature of the atmosphere will decide. So, see, rain will be formed in the droplets. And snow, it is a snow. And sleet, smaller droplets. Okay, smaller vapor passes through air, it is very cold, as a water vapor will be crystallized form and builds into a snowflake. This is a some pieces of turn into ice and it is coated more with and pushed up to freeze again also. So this is a hail. It is all depending on the atmosphere. Lower atmosphere increases the hail. It will hail. If the more lower temperature is there, it will lead to hail. And that means the lower temperature determines this rain, snow, sleet, hail. So rain falls when the air temperature are above freezing. That means if the temperature is above the 0 degrees, it will be formed as a rain. Sleet occurs when the raindrops fall through freezing air near Earth's surface. The drops turn into pellets of the ice. So if the rain droplets reaches the through freezing air, so it will be formed as a sleet. So raindrops fall through the freezing air near a surface. The raindrops turn into pellets of ice. It will be called as a sleet. That means small ice cubes. Snow. Snow falls when water vapor passes through the air that is very cold. As a result, the water vapor crystallizes and builds into snowflakes. So this is snowflakes. Water vapor crystallized. Here, water will be formed in the water droplets only. Here, water drops turn into pellets of ice. Here, water vapor crystallizes and builds into snowflakes. So, hail forms when thunderstorm winds push water back up into the atmosphere. The water which turns into ice is coated with more water and pushed up into freeze again. So, water vapor again freeze again. So this process repeat until the hailstone is heavy enough to fall. So this process will be heavy. That means it is enough to fall. Activity sum. So droughts and water scarcity. So droughts and farm 4 to 5 students and discuss the following topics in each group. Prepare and submit a group report. The topic to be discussed here. Group 1. For group 1, you will give this question. They will write the answers for this question. And from group 2, you will give this question to the some of the children. For group 3, we will give this question to answer for the some of. They will collect the information and write the answers for this question. So from group 4. And first one, what will happen if rainfall this year is less than the last year? That means only this year only less we will get less rainfall. And what will happen if rainfall this year is less than the last year? It may cause less production of crop yield compared to last year. Less production of the crop yield and depleted of water levels. Water levels will be decreases. And water scarcity and atmospheric temperature is all. Water scarcity increases and temperature of atmosphere is also increases. What would happen if there was no rainfall for 5 years? So if there was no rainfall for 5 years, causes drought condition. The land should become like this only. So drought conditions. During drought conditions, all the water sources will be dried up. And there will be no vegetation. The land should be dried like this. And animals also die due to lack of fodder. That means there is no availability of grass also. the soil will be getting dried and crackled like this. Some breakages are appear on the land also. Drinking water is also scarce. The availability of drinking water is also less. And next group, what could be the possible reason for water scarcity in a particular place? Only one place. So water scarcity may be caused by the climatic change due to deforestation or pollution from industries. So they may be in one place, particular place only, they won't get water. The reasons for maybe pollution or deforestation are the reasons. And less amount of rainfall may lead to so many problems. What the above said, either all those are water scarcity problems. So many years leads to water scarcity. And what problems can arise due to water scarcity in a particular place? So it is very difficult to get food and fodder, even food for us and fodder for animals we did not get properly. And drinking water is also scarce, and people need to travel long distance to collect the more water. And soil becomes dry and cracked, and agriculture and cultivation becomes difficult. And people migrate to other places in search of jobs. So these are all the reasons for water scarcity in a particular places. In our region, there is no rain for a longer period. It may cause droughts. During this period, it is very difficult to get food and fodder. Drinking water is scarce. People need to travel long distance to collect water. Soil becomes dry and agriculture and cultivation becomes difficult. So this question, you have to write this answer. So there is no rainfall for longer period, cause droughts. 1, 2, during this period, it is very difficult to get food and fodder, and drinking water is scarce. People need to travel long time to collect water, and soil becomes dry and agriculture cultivation becomes difficult. Many people who depend on farming, their livelihood migrate to other places to take search of jobs. In one area, particularly water scarcity in particular place, these problems will be happen. Then for people also move to other places in search of jobs. In our state, like Anantapur, Kadapa, Karnool districts are drought prone areas. So from these areas, people will be migrate to another places to search of jobs. So water will also decide where to live or happy life also. Okay. So next, drought affects our life. Here is a letter written by Ramana for you. Try to understand how drought affects our lives. See, if drought conditions are there, how it will damage our life. Discuss the following points. Dear Firoz, Ramana writing for a Firoz. I hope you find there. Nowadays, we are facing severe problems due to drought. So when will drought conditions, if there are more years, there is no rainfall, therefore places will get drought conditions. So for the last 5 years, we have no rains. All of our fields have dried and there are cracks in them. We failed to grow any crop. My father invested money on the borewells with no result. Now we get water after a great struggle from the borewell, which is 5 kilometers from our village. The days have become very bad to me. Several people have sold their cattle and migrated to Hyderabad and Bengaluru. My family also wants to do so. I request you to ask your parents to search for a job for my father at your place. My father may have been a well-known rich farmer here, but he is willing to do any kind of job there. Even though his father has a rich farmer, but without rainfall or without water, he can't do anything. He don't want to do any job from there. So yours loving friend, Ramana. Okay. And what problems did Ramana face? Ramana faced several problems due to drought. What are the problems? See. Have no rains. All our fields have dried and there are cracks in them. One, one point, first point. We failed to grow any crop. My father invested on money on borewells with no result. Now we get water after a great struggle from the borewell, which is 5 kilometers long from me. So these have been very bad, and our feet dried and there are cracks on them. So these three points you should write here. And even people also migrated from several people have sold their cattle and migrated to Hyderabad and Bangalore. So these are all in search of a job also. Okay, my people are migrated in search of job. So for all these you have to write here. How can Firoz help him? So Firoz's father can search a job for Ramana's father to escape from the crucial drought conditions. So water scarcity is a problem in some districts of our state, as mentioned earlier. Which districts? Anantapur, Kadapa, and Anantapur C. Earlier, Anantapur, Kadapa, and Kurnool. In our state, these districts face drought conditions in their places. Here, rainfall is less, and farmers are largely dependent on the irrigation using underground water to raise crops. What will happen if a farmer grows crop that require more water in these districts? What will happen when a farmer grows a crop that required more water in drought area? It leads to water scarcity, one, and it increases the investment of the crop also, and it reduces the groundwater level, and it makes more expensive to dig deep wells. Moreover, it is a hot condition, so the crops do not give good yield also. Even though they invest more money to dig the bore wells, but due to high temperature, even the crop also did not give much yield. So here, investment is more than the production. If several bore wells are dug and underground water is tapped constantly, what will happen to the source of the groundwater? If we dug several times, tapped constantly, then what will happen? The groundwater level will be decreased more and more. To get water, farmers to need dig deep bore wells, which are very expensive, and it continues for some time. Bore wells also will be dried up. So let us say these are all the less rainfall situations. Then activity 9, floods and natural hazard. That means much rainfall leads to floods. Observe this picture. And what this picture tells? So this picture tells about the floods. That means much rainfall. Does excessive rainfall certain area of our country lead to such a condition? Yes. Recently, we seen the situations in Madras, Kerala, and Hyderabad also. So, are there any other reasons that can lead to these situations? Yes. These are the reasons. What is this one? Pollution. And climate change also. That means if the climate has more temperature or less temperature, so climate change. And deforestation also. Deforestation. And El Nino. The movement of the winds from the other countries. And some of the factors, sir. These are all the factors. Have you ever faced a heard about the flood and write about your explanation? Already you have seen in some news articles and in TV news channels also. Yes, I heard about the floods named Hudhudin in our state in 2004, Titli in 2018. So a powerful Titli cyclone tore into coastal areas of Odisha and Andhra Pradesh with winds up to 150 km per hour. About 3 lakh people have been evacuated from the low-lying districts in Odisha. Roads are blocked and power supply have been lost in many areas. There is no shortage of drinking water in many areas. So these are all the problems we are faced during Hudhud, and lot of electricity also power will be lost. And National Disaster Relief Force (NDRF), the state disaster relief force, local fire, health, police, and revenue department work in coordination during floods and natural disasters. Military also participate in the relief activities wherever necessary. See, think, air and water are freely available in the nature, but now people have to pay for water along with the other commodities also. So find out from your parents and grandparents whether they also paid for water. No, they are, the water is really available for them. But nowadays the water is, even the underground water is available for freely for us, but there is no chance to drink the water directly. So they have a lot of salinity, the TDS of the total dissolved salts are more than the required amount. So think why demand for water is increasing day by day. The main reasons for water scarcity are three. The first one is a population explosion, and second one is a uneven distribution of rainfall. Third one is a decline of groundwater table, and fourth one is a pollution of water, and fifth one is a careless use of water. We should use water judiciously to prevent scarcity of water. Otherwise, it is impossible for organisms to live on the earth. We have to use water very judiciously. The only method of the preventing scarcity of the water is conservation of water. Saving water for the future generations by using water judiciously help in the conservation of water. That means the water, we do not waste the water, we use judiciously the water only. So methods of water conservation, these are the reasons for water scarcity. The reasons, what are the reasons for water scarcity are population explosion, uneven distribution of rainfall, decline of groundwater table, and pollution of water, and careless use of water. So these are all the reasons for water scarcity. And methods of water conservation are mainly, here they gave two methods can be followed for the water conservation. The first one is a proper water management. Water management consists of the following factors. That means bringing awareness about the bad effects of throwing waste into the water bodies. That means we did not throw any waste material into the water bodies. And recycling of the water by separating pollutants. Minimizing the use of chemical fertilizers in agriculture. It reduces the pollution of the underground water. That means we have to encourage the natural fertilizers in agriculture, and fertilizers and as well as the natural pesticides also. And controlling deforestation, that means we have to increase the reforestation, that means again we plant the plants only. Adapting drip irrigation and sprinkler irrigation in agriculture. In this way, lesser amount of water can be used for irrigation. And not only for that, each and every drop will be utilized by the plants. If we adapt the water, provide water through the canals, so it reaches the plants. Before it reaches the plants, a lot of water will be evaporated in the escape. So adapting drip irrigation for this method, not only we save the water, we save the electricity also. So rainwater harvesting, direct collection and use of rainwater is called rainwater harvesting. There are two types of rainwater harvesting. The first one is a collecting water from the where it falls. That means collecting water from the rooftops of the houses or buildings. Roof water, it will be called as a roof water harvesting. Next, collecting flowing rainwater. Collecting rainwater by constructing ponds with the bund. We cannot live in a single day without water. Arjun decided water is precious, and let us not waste even a single drop of water. We must preserve water not only for us, but also for future generations also. So this is the lesson and what we have learned. We need water for domestic agriculture and industrial purpose. We get water from the sources like ponds, lakes, rivers, etc. Of the water available on the earth, only 3% of it is fresh water. So we have to use water very judiciously only. And Water on the earth can exist in three forms. Ice, water in the form will be called as solid form. The liquid form of water will be called as a water, and the gaseous form of water will be called as a water vapor. The process of changing of water into water vapor is called as a evaporation. Evaporation of water from the water surface of the seas, lakes, ponds, etc. is a part of cloud formation. So clouds are formed by a tiny droplets of water vapor. How clouds are formed? With the tiny droplets of water vapor, the clouds will be formed. The process of condensation. What is condensation? The process of water vapor, conversion of water vapor into water will be called as a condensation. The cycle of evaporation, condensation, and what condensation of water present on the earth's surface cause rain. So, what are the causes for rain? Evaporation and condensation. Rain, snow, sleet, hail are any kind of weather condition where something's falling from the sky is called precipitation. The conversion of water into water vapor to clouds, clouds to rain is known as a water cycle. So water into water vapor, evaporation. Water vapor to clouds is a condensation. So evaporation. Clouds to rain is a condensation. Long period of less rainfall usually causes droughts and famines. And floods are natural disasters that affect the human life. The amount of usable water on the earth is limited, so it needs to be used very carefully. So the process of changing water into vapor is called as a evaporation. Next, the water cycle is also called as a hydrological cycle. Next, no rainfall for a year, no more may lead to drought in that region. Less rainfall leads to drought in these regions. Next, excessive rain may cause floods. We have discussed all these points already. Next one. The nature of the sea water is the nature of how the name is salty. Next, which of the following is not a part of a water cycle? Evaporation is first, second one is a condensation, rain, and distillation is not a process of a water cycle. And which of the following process add water vapor to the atmosphere? So add water vapor, evaporation. And after next video we will discuss all these question and answers from the next video. Okay, next video we will discuss all these questions in. Okay, thank you for watching this video. Please like my video, share my videos to your friends, and subscribe my channel and click on the bell icon.